Good morning. Mindful Monday. It's 8:05 a.m. Now, I have played this song, You Loving Me, Yoga World Dance by Earthrise Sound System and these others over and over because I love this song. So let's get into a little bit of a groove. Then we're going to anchor. Then we're going to talk about choosing optimism. Training our brain. We're also going to drink a little coffee. Something that literally activates you into your joy so you can begin your day in that realm of possibility. So when I wake up, and I try not to put on music too early because of my neighbors, it just supports me in being present to my body, to my breath. Coffee! That's right, Jody Roberts. It is coffee with Veronica. Coffee time with Bea. We're going to anchor, and then we're going to talk about choosing optimism, because there is science behind everything I teach you. Even the dancing, there's science behind how it affects your body, because your brain's releasing that dopamine. Just a few more beats. You Loving Me, Yoga World Dance, Up World. Now trust me, I don't wake up dancing. I wake up because of this. I'm telling you. All right, let's get ready. Make sure you're comfortable. I'm going to turn this off, like, just real quick. We're going to pause it. And it is true. When I wake up at 5 in the morning, I don't wake up dancing. I wake up in gratitude. And I sometimes am groggy. I woke up at 1:11 a.m. this morning. Took a picture of it. So this morning was a little bit slower when the alarm went off, but then it's like I redirect my brain. Like I first presence that I'm feeling tired. It's like, oh, I could use a couple more hours of sleep. And so I want to acknowledge that. In mindfulness, I want to be present in the moment with, you know, openness and curiosity. And then I do my gratitude practice. And I do. I thank, you know, the loving universe for having a roof over my head and having my bed. Being able to actually go to the bathroom and there's running water and I have a toilet. There's a lot of people around the world who don't. And then I come in to my kitchen, I get my little espresso maker ready, put that organic Peruvian coffee. The second cup is organic Indonesian, but I'm in gratitude for that. How many people had to come together with Mother Earth to have those coffee beans grown, then picked, then shipped, then roasted, and then ready for me to get. All right, so it's a gratitude group. So let's anchor, and then we're going to talk about choosing optimism. It's all about that perspective. How am I seeing the world? How am I training my brain? And then for me, it's really the heartfulness, but this is all brain science that we have for the mindfulness. So I'm going to invite you to get into your mindful body like I do with the kids. Whatever hand you want to put, right hand on heart, left on belly, or you do the heart math way, left hand on heart, one on belly, and just allow yourself to settle into the moment. And notice if you're sitting down, how your body actually feels. And try to sit up where you're straight but comfortable, meaning your back, your spine is, you know, straight, like a little string on the top of your head that just kind of brings you up a little bit. And your shoulders back, your neck and your jaw and your head just relax. We want to relax into the moment, but at the same time, we want to be awake. So I share with the kids, if I'm leaning over this way, trying to do mindful breathing, not going to be working. All right. So get into your mindful body. We're going to do 3 bells, then just sit for a few breaths, and then we're going to have a conversation, and then we're going to dance out. It's Mindful Monday. But every day is a day to be mindful. Every moment when I bring my attention back to this moment, that is a mindful moment, my friends. So mindful bodies, let's anchor together. Your eyes are closed. And allow yourself just to be present to your breath. Like literally bring your attention. By bringing your attention to your breath, feeling the air coming in through your nose and out through your mouth, we're literally creating neural connections. Every time our mind wanders and we bring it back, we're creating neural connections. So breathe in. And then as you breathe out, just relax into this moment, noticing how you feel. Breathe in. And breathe out. Just noticing any sensations. not judging them or labeling them, just feeling them. Breathe in. And breathe out. Now put your hands on your lap. I'm going to keep mine on my heart so you can see if anybody comes online. We're just going to sit for a few breaths together. I'm going to be quiet, but just focus on your breath. It's okay if your mind wanders. Just treat them like clouds. Let them, like, notice them. Let them float on by. Or as I share with the children, pop them like a bubble. All right? So in this moment, bring your attention to your breath, breathing in. And breathing out. And on your own, that little circular dance of the inhalation and exhalation, just bringing ourselves fully in this moment, right here, right now. Breathe in. And breathe out. And just continue till you hear the sound of my bell. Breathing in and breathing out, just letting it all be. Let's open our eyes. Good morning. How grateful I am to be here. And understanding that during this time, there are a lot of people who are having a lot of challenges. And so I want to be mindfulness in action, compassion in action. Any way that I can support you in prayer or connection, but also ways to donate to people. I donate $5 here, $10 there, $20 there. But it is the reminder that we are given this time to literally tune within and not have a to-do list a mile long. But today I want to talk about choosing optimism. So with the kids, we've been talking about emotions, paying attention to what we're feeling, the emotion in the moment where it's landing. But choosing optimism is a way of seeing life through the lens of opportunity and possibility. We are wired for negativity. Our brain is wired to keep us safe. And with neuroplasticity, the brain science of neuroplasticity, I can rewire my brain. Now, I can tell you in my younger years, I was much more fearful and probably much more pessimistic just based on the stress and experience of life that I had. And it literally took a long-term illness and then starting to shift my brain in ways with positive statements and claiming my good that I literally rewired my brain, that I tend to be more optimistic than pessimistic. Now, trust me, I have my difficult emotions. Trust me, I do. But I've noticed a difference even in my journal writing when I go back and look that the way that I've transformed is because I had to train my brain. Now, I'm very heart-centered, so my heart has a greater resonance to bring me into coherence, but I didn't know that as a kid. So in choosing optimism, we're identifying the possibilities, and especially for children, that when something is hard, we don't just stop in that moment or don't even try. We got to create strategies that support the possibility that, you know, I'm capable of learning something new. Excuse me, allergies. I look at life from the lens of that it's half full instead of half empty. So that whole glass, half full, half empty. Here's the way I look at life, all right? I look at it as a coffee cup. And if my coffee, which is about halfway here, I don't say it's half empty. I don't even say it's half full. I just say there's room to add more. Now, that's a very optimistic way of seeing things, all right? But what we know in neuroscience, it's a learned skill. Optimism is a learned skill. We have to train our brain. And by doing so, we're creating greater connections in our brain. So I'm not a neuroscientist. I teach very basic brain science. But the neurons are just the way that the messages of the neurotransmitters just really get to each other, right? And I want to be operating from this part of my brain, my prefrontal cortex. I want to be making excellent decisions. I want my heart leading and has my brain in alignment. You know, very, very basic heart math. But in every time that I am tuning into optimism, I'm creating stronger connections. And there's like these little, the neurons have like these little dendrites, like little fingers like this. And the more that I am having optimistic thoughts and creating possibilities, more of these dendrites, so the more capacity for that message to get faster to my prefrontal cortex. So when that part of my brain, my amygdala starts to flip, boom, it's right here. It's like, oh, I got it. I got it. Wise leader has got it. So I have to train my brain. I have to watch myself talk. I have to notice behavior patterns. Do I limit myself in any way? How do I keep trying? That I understand a growth mindset, that making mistakes is good. That's how I learn and grow. I used to tell the kids at school, I go, if school is too easy, then you're in the wrong class. Because it's not supposed to be easy, because every time we learn something new, we create stronger connections, we move to the next level. So choosing optimism, I want you to like pay attention throughout your day. And notice your own facial expression in the mirror or on other people. Am I in a place of openness? You know, I tell the kids, optimism is being open. Pessimism is this, you're closed. You're stuck. Like you're not even gonna try to have another belief system or choose a different way of thinking. So in the Mind Up curriculum, they have the kids create a happy and sad phase. But what I'm offering you is that opportunity just to take a look at the way that you see life. What are you focusing on? And then retrain your brain to find the good and to look at the possibility and to create a place from a more empowered opportunity. All right. So choosing optimism, we have to train our brain. All right. So we're finding the good. We have a perspective of possibility. We look at things that we're learned, you know, and this whole crisis right now is inviting us into a new creative way of being. I'm watching people evolve their business or their personal life through things that are very challenging. Loss of business, loss of, you know, opportunities. But at the same time, from an optimistic place, then I can like one presence what I'm feeling, the emotion that I'm feeling. I'm feeling nervous. I'm concerned. I'm worried. I really value understanding and clarity and support. And then look at it from the lens of like you're putting on your little binoculars, like a friend of mine did with kids yoga, and look at it from the lens of opportunity. What is seeking to arise in this moment? And then use your imagination and start imagining these new opportunities. So I'm literally watching people revamp their business or create new opportunities. Now, this isn't a time of being over creative, a to-do list a mile long. It really is a time of tuning within. But if you choose to look from the lens of optimism, of possibilities, not only are you creating greater neural connections so that when this starts to flip, I get to this part of my brain, I am dropping in my heart, I'm in alignment with the possibility, I can stand in the moment with openness and curiosity, and then at the same time, I can choose. I get to choose how I see the world, how I'm going to be in the world, what am I going to co-create moment by moment, all right? So we are choosing optimism today. This does not negate all the challenges that people are experiencing. This does not negate those who may be having different experiences, brain experiences, because there are biological components to our brain. All right. So I do know that for some people, when it's cloudy like this and it's gray, it brings a level of depression on them. But what I am saying is that we can train our brain. We can choose optimism. We can create this growth mindset of possibility. And we're literally rewiring our brain. So like I said earlier, is your glass half full, half empty? How are you seeing it? Don't judge yourself and then shift it. And like I said, with my coffee, because I'm halfway there, it's not that it's half full. There's room to add more. So are you ready to add more good? That's the whole point of this conversation this morning. All right. Have a little sip of coffee with me. Appreciate the deliciousness of it all. And take this opportunity as a way to create a new world by choosing optimism. Now, we call what we need to call into accountability, but this is our opportunity with mindfulness to be present in the moment, open and curious, noticing what we're feeling, and at the same time, we're going to choose optimism. We're going to create possibilities. We're going to move through challenges with a greater strength. We're going to shift our awareness to our potentiality and not, you know, the fear of this or the loss of that. Let's bear witness to that. But which way are we going to move? We're going to be pulled by new vision, right? So we're going to dance out to You Loving Me. You know, there's another one that I like too. Maybe we'll dance out to this one. Desert dance. All right, we're going to dance out. So I'm inviting you to choose optimism, because literally there'll be more dopamine, less stress, open to possibilities, all right? And then when you dance, you move the energy, okay? And have some good coffee, good tea, or whatever good juice that you drink. Just have a mindful day. Just remember, I'm here for you. Connect with the ones you love. Connect with me if you need extra support. Just know that you're loved. And you're supported, and by choosing optimism, we're going to co-create a world of the greater possibilities, not just for me, not just for you, for all of us, all right? We're changing the world. So I'm going to invite us to anchor, so mindful body. We're going to dance it out. Here we go. Breathing in and breathing out. Let's create a better world, people. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out, be present, choose optimism, drop into your heart, open to the possibilities, see with eyes that see clearly beyond any limitation, all right? And be kind to yourself. If you've been wired for years to be in pessimism and negativity, don't judge yourself. Just move into a greater way, level of awareness. On a human level, we're training our brain, we're coming into our heart, and we are aligning in our good. Have a magnificent day. I'll post these two songs. Get your groove on today. If you are healthy and you have a safe place to be and you have plenty of food, let's start in gratitude. And then let's share that good with others, right? Peace. It's Veronica, Miss V. It's Mindful Monday. But every moment is a moment to be mindful. I love you.